Cotton is an agricultural product. It is cultivated in the tropical and subtropical areas and required almost uniform high temperature varying between 21 degrees centigrade to 30 degrees centigrade, and it requires very moderate rainfall. That is from the agricultural point of view. And frost is the enemy number one of this cotton plant. And you can see the cotton is actually a kharif crop which requires 6 to 8 months to mature, and its time of sowing and harvesting differs in different parts of the country depending upon the climatic conditions. In Punjab and Haryana, it is sown in April and May and is harvested in December to January, that is before the winter frost can damage the crop. But in the peninsular part of the country, it is sown up to October harvested between January to May anytime, because there is no danger of frost. And in Tamil Nadu, it is grown both as a kharif crop as well as a rabi crop. Cotton cultivation is closely related to deep black soils of the Deccan and Malwa plateau and of those of Gujarat. The cotton quickly exhausts the fertility of the soil. That is the characteristic of this particular plant. So therefore, the regular application of manures and fertilizers are very necessary. So these are the cotton plants. It looks like that when it is grown. And after the blooming of cotton, it is called cotton ball, the fully grown, you can see it is like this. After opening of the ball, the cotton fibers are visible. Then your picking is done. Picking is actually very crucial from the labor point of view, since picking cotton is done purely manually. It is not yet been mechanized, and a lot of cheap and efficient labor is required. And normally the picking season is spread over a period of about 3 months. This is how the cotton is picked manually. And as far as the topography of the cultivation is there, India has the largest cotton cultivation in the world, followed by China and USA. Till recently, India was number 3, USA was the number 1, China was number 2. Now it has come to number 1 in the last 2-3 years. In spite of the fact that though practically there is no increase in the area under cultivation since last several decades. But because of the high yielding newer varieties of cotton seeds, we could achieve the higher productivity. Now there are broadly 3 types of cotton, which are generally categorized on the basis of length, which is technically called staple length. So long staple cotton, medium staple cotton, or short staple cotton. Long staple cotton is from 24 to 27 millimeter, and it is produced in these states, Punjab, Haryana, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu. Our 50% production is of long staple cotton. Longer the fiber, better it is, because you can spin finer yarns with long staple cotton. You must have heard malmal. Malmal is a variety of cotton cloth which is so fine that we used to hear that Dhaka malmal, which is produced in Bangladesh, it used to be so fine that one thaan of the cotton could pass through a ring. It's so fine. So that is possible because of the length of the cotton fiber. Then we have medium staple cotton. It ranges from 20 to 24 millimeter, and around 44% of the cotton production in India is of medium staple. So 50% is long staple, 44% is medium staple, and rest 6% is short staple. Short staple fiber is used for manufacturing coarser yarns. Then we have different yarn manufacturing technologies where short fibers can also be, like for example, for spinning denim yarn, jeans in spin, use hota hai, that denim yarn is thicker, coarser. So there you can use coarse quality short fiber yarns, that is cheaper. Then almost 65% of the area under cultivation cotton is rain fed with erratic and poorly distributed rains during the cropping season, and it is also subjected to pests and all. But this rainfall that can be adjusted with the artificial irrigation, so that is not a problem for them. Now this is one thing I wanted to add, the GM cotton, like BT cotton. This is genetically modified cotton. So this is BT cotton. So this bacterium naturally produces a chemical which is harmful only to a small fraction of insects, relevant insects like bollworm, and most notably the larvae of these, and harmless to other forms of life. The gene coding of BT toxin is inserted into cotton, causing cotton to produce this natural insecticides in this tissues. With the advent of, I am telling you, this BT cotton, the cotton production has grown many fold in India. Because otherwise, with the attack of bollworm, wo puri ki puri fasal wo kharab ho jati thi. So This is permitted in India. Now, this is the cotton fiber. Enlarged view of cotton fiber. It looks like this. It has a flat thing, twisted, slightly twisted. And when we will show you the cross section, it is hollow also. Something like rubber tube flattened and twisted. One type of saw gin, you can see the typical. Here the cotton is fed, cotton fibers are separated through blades, and the cotton seeds are separated. This is a demonstrative picture of the ginning machine. In actual, ginning machine looks like this. Now the fiber, that is technically called lint. Lint is separated from the cotton ball, and cotton seeds are separated. Then the lint or the cotton fibers are compacted, pressed, and made in a shape of rectangular bale. These are cotton bales, packs of cotton wrapped with cotton cloth and then strapped. We will be certifying these cotton bales. So there is a standard IS 12171, sorry, this is a mistake. This is 2013 cotton bale specification with amendment number 2. So now, as Varsha explained, the characteristics of cotton, the parameters which determine the value of cotton, one is the staple length. Staple length is actually very important from the view of manufacturing of textiles, because all the spinning machines, right from the blow room to the ring frame, all the machine settings are based on the staple length. The textile technologist calculate what settings should be there for this particular staple length. Otherwise, what will happen? The fibers will break or it will not be spun with minimum. So staple length is very important. Micronear is finer the higher the micronear, finer the fiber, finer the yarn we can spin. This is the requirement of the existing Indian standard. You have to mark the name of variety of cotton, whether it is J34, it's Shankar 6 or whatever. Then press mark number, then press running number, mass of pressed bale, crop year, station in case of export country, and any other information required by law in force. And if agreed between the buyer and the seller, staple length and micronear value may also be marked on the label. That is was not mandatory, but now we are going to make it mandatory as per the requirement of the ministry. We did not earlier think that it was essential, because cotton is a natural fiber. You cannot change the staple length or micronear value. So you cannot make it as a requirement. You can only declare it on the bale. So now, in order to achieve the objectives of standardization of Indian cotton bale in terms of weight, dimensions, moisture, trash, quality of packaging, identification of cotton bale in relation to quality parameters of the fiber, and to curb unfair trade practices like adding moisture. These are the unfair, they generally, those ginners resort to adding moisture, adding salt, not removing trash and contamination, and mixing of varieties. Though mixing is done before manufacturing the textiles, that I'll give you a brief thing. Now the Ministry of Textiles has decided to bring Indian standard cotton bale specification IS 1271/2013 under mandatory conformity assessment scheme under Bureau of Indian Standards Act 2016. So in this certification scheme, the BIS shall be the certifying and enforcing authority for the implementation of the proposed cotton bale marking order 2018, and the conformity assessment scheme will operate on as based on the type testing of the product and as a in a third party laboratory similar to type 2 of scheme of ISO IEC 170, something similar to the registration scheme. So in this scheme, BIS will grant license to manufacturers. In this case, manufacturers will be ginning and pressing factories. Like what happens presently, like Cotton Corporation of India, they purchase cotton from the farmers in huge quantity, and they give it to various ginners and pressing factories. Then they get the pressed bales, packed bales, they mark it as Cotton Corporation of India bale and then supply it to textile mills. So, but we will be giving license only to ginners. And based on submission of the test report of the product sample from a BIS recognized third party laboratory and verification of the same by BIS, ensuring conformity of the product to the relevant standard. So this is our plan of operation.